Thanks for tuning in today. You can see that my dogs are very interested in this chocolate that I have here. And today I wanted to talk to you about what you should do if your dog does eat chocolate. We all hear that chocolate is poisonous to dogs. Some people think it's maybe an old wives' tale because they've had a dog that's eaten chocolate and nothing happened. Others are terrified that their dog might ingest any chocolate. The basics to remember with chocolate is the darker and the more bitter, the more toxic it is to your dog. White chocolate is not toxic because it's not actually made with cocoa. The reason that chocolate is toxic to dogs is because it is made with the roasted seed of the cocoa plant, and that those contain theobromine. Dogs don't metabolize theobromine as fast as humans do, so it builds up in their system quicker and becomes toxic to them. The thing to remember, as I mentioned, is the darker the chocolate and the more bitter, the more toxic it is. So baker's chocolate and dark chocolate are kind of the worst, where milk chocolate, not quite so bad. And again, white chocolate is not toxic at all. Too much chocolate can have negative effects on your dog's cardiovascular and nervous system, among other things. If it's just a small amount, you can keep an eye on your dog for signs of chocolate poisoning. And those would be things like tremors, muscle spasms, seizures, an abnormal heart rate, either slower than normal or more typically faster than normal, or a sudden collapse. If you notice any of these signs, you don't want to worry about dealing with this problem at home. You want to get your dog to the vet immediately. If you don't notice these signs, if your dog's just ingested the chocolate, the best thing to do is to induce vomiting to try and get it out of his system as quickly as possible. I have made a video guide specifically on inducing vomiting in a dog, and you can watch that. If you click the link below this video, it will take you there and you can check that out so you can see the step-by-step instructions. But basically, you're going to use 3% hydrogen peroxide and you're going to give it to your dog orally. It's about a teaspoon for every 5 pounds of body weight, but you don't want to go over 3 tablespoon doses. So there are 3 teaspoons in a tablespoon. If you have a really large dog, you're only going to give 3 tablespoons. You're going to give the dose, the appropriate dose for your dog, orally. You can use a syringe to squirt the hydrogen peroxide into their mouth and make sure they swallow it, and then wait 5 minutes. If the dog hasn't vomited within 5 minutes, you can give one more dose. So you'll give the same dose again, and hopefully that should induce vomiting. If after the second dose your dog has not vomited, you need to call your vet immediately. Do not give any more than 2 doses. Call your vet immediately. Let them know. The best thing to do is have all the information when you call your vet. So what type of chocolate they ate, how much of it they ate, and when they ate it. So before you do anything, if your dog ever does eat chocolate, the one thing that you want to do is just quickly make a mental note of that information. What type of chocolate, about what time it is, and about how much of it they ate. And then you can try to induce vomiting, but if you do need to call your vet or take them to the vet, you can give them that information because that's going to be very important. If you guys have any other questions, feel free to email me. Thanks for watching this video guide.